What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Cafe and Views. Today, I'm joined by music producer Amadou Khan. Today, we're doing a dual review about the Sidecar Cafe. And me, myself, got the Black Onyx.
What's going on, everybody? I'm glad to be on Cafe and Views. Today, I got the Vietnamese iced coffee.
Now, we're going to be talking about the cafe. Let's get into it. So Sidecar Donuts and Coffee is located on Wilshire Boulevard, so it's not too far from the beach. So if you wanted to take this coffee, you can just head down maybe a mile and drink this coffee on the beach.
Side Cafe is a great location, known primarily for their donuts. It's a great atmosphere inside the store. Staff is very helpful. You order your donuts and then you move over in front of your coffee order and it's made right in front of you.
So as you can see, they have an ample amount of donuts on display. So it depends on what kind of coffee you get is what kind of donut you get. So there's a specialty based on that.
And what I like about their coffee selection is they have seasonal options.
So this coffee shop doesn't really have seating inside, but the seating outside, there's an ample amount of space. There's seating right next to the sidewalk. So if you want to get a view of the street, you're also able to do that. And then there's also four different tables that are closer to the shop, so if you kind of want to get away from that ambient noise from the road and from the buses, you're better off doing that. So their menu is not as extensive and they don't have a lot of different unique options to choose from. The black coffee and the Vietnamese coffee are the two different options that you can get that are different than the norm.
The atmosphere is really dope. The baristas inside the store are super helpful. They help you pick out a nice donut. They have different options. They let you know exactly what's in each donut, what flavors bring it in, especially including their seasonal options that aren't always available.
So for the overall score of the coffee shop, we're gonna put this at a 4 out of 5. Let's go talk about acidity.
Starting off with acidity, this is a Vietnamese iced coffee. Typically, they're not very acidic because they're a dark roast blend. So for acidity, I'm gonna go very low on this one. It's a more full-flavored and bold taste.
So for me, I'm getting more of a sour note that comes across from this coffee. Although it's a mocha, I am still getting that sour bitterness from the chocolate. If you were to bite into a chocolate bar, I'm getting the same exact type of bitterness and sourness from the coffee. It's still providing that mellow and tame type of feeling, but you are kind of getting a little bit of that sharpness from the bitterness, but it's not too over the top.
Very, like I mentioned, balanced taste, full flavored, low acidity, and I like that taste in my coffee. For acidity, I'm gonna go ahead and give this one a 4 out of 5.
For the Black Onyx, the acidity, I'm gonna put this about at a 3 out of 5. Next up on the list, we're gonna be talking about aroma. So with this coffee's aroma, it's kind of toned down. The chocolate is more pronounced in the flavor and in the taste than the actual aroma. You're not getting too much in terms of that chocolatey mocha sensation, but it is still pleasant. You are still getting that nice chocolatey aroma and it's still kind of is enhancing the coffee, but not as much as I would like it to. And you do have to lean into it quite a bit to actually get that prominent smell. It's not attracting me for more as much as I would want it to be. For me, for aroma, I'm gonna put this at about a 2 out of 5.
Next up, aroma for me, let's check it out. So for this aroma, nothing really sticks out. It's kind of one of those smells where it is a dark roast, so it'll give you a traditional coffee shop smell, a traditional smell of coffee that most people are familiar with. Nothing really sticks out here, and the ingredients I had really on top of it is the cream and the half and half. You can kind of get a little bit of flavor that it has that cream in there, but like I mentioned, nothing really sticks out. It's a very flat aroma, so I'm gonna give this one a 3 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be aftertaste. Kind of with sweetness and with body, the coffee is changing because it is more bitter in the beginning and now it's starting to become more sweet. So the aftertaste is kind of changing the coffee. The initial sip is bitter and then when it's in your mouth and you're able to kind of dissect the coffee, it's sweet. And then when you finally swallow the coffee, it's starting to become a little bit more bitter because you're getting that chocolate taste that's coming out and becoming more prominent than it was in the flavor. It's creating that kind of chocolatey trail. So if you ever watched Willy Wonka or Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and you can imagine that chocolate scene where the kid is drinking out of the lake, that's what the coffee is kind of reminding you of. So as I'm drinking the coffee more and more, my mind is going to that location and it's kind of putting me in an overall better mood because that was a really great movie. And chocolate is one of my favorite notes to have in a coffee. For me, for aftertaste, I'm gonna put this at about a 4 out of 5.
The bitterness on the Vietnamese iced coffee, it's very dry and bitter. It does leave you wanting to take another sip. I will say that the cream flavor that's not really present when you first take a sip is a little bit stronger after you take that sip and the aftertaste settles in. I will say for a strong coffee, you typically are gonna have that bitter aftertaste. I think it's meant to kind of be sipped slower rather than consistently. Even though it's a stronger coffee and you kind of expect to have that bitter aftertaste because it's meant to be sipped slow, I'm still gonna go ahead and give this one a 3 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be balance. Along with aftertaste and a body and the flavor and the sweetness kind of changing, the coffee is slightly becoming unbalanced. So it's all dependent on your personal taste. If you like to have two unique experiences when you're drinking a coffee, or if you like to have the same consistent experience where it's sweet all throughout, or if it starts out bitter and becomes sweet, or sweet and becomes bitter. So it's up to you to see if you actually enjoy that kind of slight change. But as you keep drinking the coffee and you keep figuring it out, and as it's changing, more of those ingredients are starting to stick out, and you are able to pick up the coffee and the milk that makes the coffee more creamy. For me, for balance, I'm gonna put this at about a 2 out of 5.
This is a fairly balanced coffee. Even though it's stronger, it doesn't hit you with a punch right away. The cream and the light amount of sugar give it just enough to complement that strong flavor. I would have preferred if there was a little bit more flavor in the cream, or as I mentioned earlier, if there was a little bit higher level of sweetness, it would be a more balanced coffee. Overall, 3 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be flavor. This is where the coffee shines a lot more than the actual aroma and acidity. You're getting a lot of that hot cocoa type of flavor. It's not as prominent as a real hot chocolate or a mocha drink. It is pleasant. It's more pleasant than the aroma, and the aroma is slightly enhanced by the flavor just because the flavor is a notch or two above aroma. So for flavor, I'm gonna put this at about a 3 out of 5.
Next up for flavor, let's see. The taste isn't very open or bright. It's very bold and strong. It's not really spicy or has flavors such as mocha or caramel or pumpkin or other those types of sweet or chocolatey flavors. It's just very simple and strong tasting. It's straight to the point. I'm gonna give it a 4 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be complexity. For the taste, the coffee is not complex because it does taste like most of the mochas that I've had. And in the beginning, it was more of a slight cacao taste. And then as I was drinking the coffee, that the hot chocolate powder and the hot chocolate flavor and feeling started becoming more prominent. The uniqueness of this coffee is not enough to make me remember this exact coffee. The complexity of the coffee shop being predominantly donut based, they're definitely doing a good job. The coffee cup is branded, so as you can tell, that's a really big plus in my book. When you're able to take the coffee and go for a walk and go relax, and somebody asks you what kind of coffee you got because it looks different or unique, you're able to tell them and show them, and they're more likely to remember that coffee. But for the aroma, it's also not as complex. The aroma is actually really toned down, so it's not as memorable as the flavor might be. For complexity, I am gonna put this at about a 2.5 out of 5.
This is the most complex or unique tasting coffee, but at the same time, I don't think it's meant to be. A coffee like this relies on its boldness to really carry the complexity. That being said, I'm gonna give it a 3 out of 5.
First up on the list is gonna be the Sage Apple Pie. Let's see how well it pairs with the Black Onyx coffee. So as you can see, the presentation is there. They really do a really good job at making sure that the full experience pairs well with the coffee. Before I even get any of the cream on top, it tastes more like a glazed Krispy Kreme donut, and then the cream on top kind of just elevates it even more, so it makes it feel a little bit of like a Boston cream type of donut. Comes at the top, just overall add to the pizzazz of the donut. If you go and get the Black Onyx from Sidecar Cafe, make sure you try out the Sage Apple Pie.
So I went with the pumpkin cheesecake donut. It has cheesecake cream on the top, pecan crumbles, pumpkin spice glaze. As you can see, the presentation is really good. It's very fluffy. The crumbs were put on just the right amount, and the cheesecake on top is drizzled perfectly. Right away, super balanced. They mentioned when I got it that it was very strong on pumpkin flavor, so this is definitely a donut for people that are into like a fall-inspired donut. You wanna pair it with the Vietnamese iced coffee that I had earlier, it's perfect. You can definitely tell they're not lying when they say that they make these donuts fresh every day. This is a great donut, given the fact that it's fall. So if you're walking on the beach, you got your Vietnamese iced coffee, this goes well hand in hand, especially when it's a little bit chilly.
So now that we reviewed the donuts, let's go back and finish the review of the coffee. All right, so next up on the list is gonna be forgiveness. Because the coffee is not complex in terms of aroma or flavor, that doesn't, you know, make it different than other mochas or other coffees that I've had, I'm not gonna forgive those categories. But the overall shop and having the donuts does bump up the characteristics slightly. You know, there are slightly more positives than negatives. So for forgiveness, I'm gonna put this at a 2 out of 5.
The knock on this coffee is its lack of a really distinct aroma, its bitter aftertaste, and its lack of not having more or enough flavor. That being said, it's really made up with its bold and strong taste. Overall for forgiveness, 2.5 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be body. The overall mouthfeel of this coffee, you do get a sense of slight creaminess, but you can tell that it has like a water-like consistency. So again, like the other coffee, it's kind of tricking you into thinking that it's a creamy coffee, but in reality, the texture is more water-like and the weight is not there. So the coffee is creamy, and then the overall coffee flavor does dissipate pretty quickly, but you are getting a little bit of that mocha that sticks around. So even when the coffee is gone, you're still able to detect the chocolate and the cacao that went into it. For me, for body, I'm gonna put this at about a 4 out of 5.
The body for the iced Vietnamese coffee, it's a little light, it's a little watery. It's not so dense as I was expecting it to be. I did have cream in there, but it feels a bit light. Maybe with extra cream, it would add a little bit more denseness to it. Overall for body, I'm gonna go 3 out of 5.
So let's talk about versatility. You can drink this coffee pretty much at any point throughout the day, anytime throughout the week. This coffee is not gonna be reserved for those special occasions that you want to enjoy a lot more. If I'm in Santa Monica in the mornings and I need a mocha, I'm gonna go pick up the Black Onyx because I like that mocha flavor. For versatility, I'm gonna put this at about a 4 out of 5.
Vietnamese iced coffee is fairly versatile. I would recommend to have it in the morning because it is a little stronger. It has kind of almost espresso levels of caffeine in it. So it does give you a little bit of that jump. So if you're used to having stronger coffee with more caffeine, and you're used to that flavor and you could take it on anytime during the day, that works for you. But for some people that may just be wanting to walk around on an afternoon stroll or just wanna be down the beach and don't really wanna get that high level of caffeine to really get their heart rate going and their mind and their body running, I wouldn't recommend it. I also wouldn't recommend this coffee as a dessert coffee because it is a little bit stronger and a little bit bitter. Some people do like to have those strong coffees after dinner. I know that, but for me personally, I prefer to have a sweeter coffee if I'm gonna have it after dinner or after lunch. Overall for versatility, this gets a 3.5 out of 5.
So next up on the list is gonna be sweetness. The sweetness is poking out slightly more, and I am getting a little bit more of a sweetness to it. So the bitterness is going away and the sweetness is coming out. In the beginning, it was more of a dark chocolate, like 80%, and now it's starting to transition more into like a milk chocolate type of sensation. And the sweetness, it's kind of enhancing the flavor a little bit. It's not washing it out. For sweetness, I'm gonna put this at about a 3 out of 5.
For me, this is slightly bitter, which is kind of what you want with a dark roast. It kind of complements the flavor a little bit more. You don't really want a bold coffee like the Vietnamese iced coffees typically are to have too much sweetness in there. That being said, a tad bit of sweetness probably would have made this one a little bit better for me. So I'm gonna give it a 4 out of 5 for sweetness.
Overall, the Black Onyx from Sidecar Cafe got a 30 out of 50 or a 60% out of 100.
Overall, the Vietnamese iced coffee from Sidecar gets a 30.5 out of 50 or 61% out of 100.
So thank you so much for watching Cafe and Views, where we went to Sidecar Cafe and I got the Black Onyx coffee.
Got the Vietnamese iced coffee. Glad to be out in Santa Monica with my man Paul. Stay tuned for Cafe and Views.
Peace.